Good morning students, welcome to Narayan online video classes. Okay, in 6th class algebra, today we are discussing about degree of a monomial. Degree of a monomial and also degree of a polynomial and what is zero polynomial and what is zero of a polynomial. Let us say first of all take degree of monomial. Monomial nothing but that is what? Only single term, that means an expression which consisting of only one term. Okay, suppose I am taking minus 2 by 3 x square y and z, let us suppose I take it. Here, this is only one term. In this term, variables indices of the x to the power 2, y to the power of 1, z to the power of 1. Okay, add both of them, 2 plus 1 plus 1, nothing but what 4. Now this is called the degree of that monomial. That means the sum of the indices of the variables in a term is called degree of that term or that monomial. Okay, next, degree of a polynomial. Polynomial nothing but that is algebraic expression in that the variables indices are positive integers. Okay, then only that expression what we call polynomial. Such type of polynomial, let us suppose I am taking here 2x square plus 3x to the power of 5 minus 4 by 3 x cube. Let us suppose I taken like this. Okay, now here how many terms are there? This is one term. Plus 3x to the power of 5 is another term. Minus 4 by 3 x cube is third term. That means terms are separated by either plus or minus. Okay. Now the degree of this term, what is that 2? The degree of this term, what is that 5? The degree of this term, what is that 3? Among all those degrees of all the terms, which is the greatest? 5. Now we say that 5 is the degree of this term, this expression. That means degree of polynomial is nothing but the highest degree of all the terms of a polynomial. I am taking a polynomial in that all the terms degrees individually we are finding. The highest degree of all the terms in a polynomial is called degree of that polynomial. Okay, that's why for this polynomial, what is the degree? 5. Next, zero polynomial. Zero polynomial nothing but what? Simply zero is nothing but zero polynomial. That means let us suppose I am taking P of x is a polynomial such that that is what? Zero. Now this is called zero polynomial. Okay, whenever we want to express like this, let us suppose px is equal to ax square plus bx plus c. Now, when it becomes zero polynomial, that means we should get zero. That means a must be zero, b must be zero, and c must be zero. 0 into x square 0, 0 into x 0, and 0. This total what is that? 0. Okay, that's why when we call this is zero polynomial, this one happens zero when the coefficients of all the terms is equal to 0. Okay, then we get that expression, what is that? 0. Okay, now 0 is called zero polynomial. Zero polynomial nothing but that is a polynomial in that the coefficients of all the terms should be equal to what? 0. Okay, that means simply 0 is the zero polynomial. Okay, zero polynomial is unique. Okay, other than 0 there is no other any other zero polynomial. Next, zero of the polynomial. Zero of the polynomial is different from zero polynomial. See, suppose I am taking 2x, suppose minus 5, is it, that is a polynomial. Let it be p of x. Now I want to find out, let us take this one. P of x is equal to x plus 3 I am taking. Of course, this is a polynomial. Now, I want to get the value of this polynomial is 0. Then, for getting the value 0, in the place of x, which one we have to substitute? Minus 3, no doubt about that, minus 3. That is equal to minus 3 plus 3, what we are getting? 0. Now, the value of the variable, if the variable is replacing by minus 3, then we are getting that expression value, what is that? 0. Now, the value of this variable, particularly we are calling 0 of this one, that means 0 of p of x is equal to x plus 3 is what? Minus 3 we are calling. That means here 0 nothing but 0 is the value of the variable in a given polynomial. Okay, for which the value of the polynomial becoming what? 0. Okay, such a value what we call 0 of the polynomial. Let us take one problem on these concepts. Okay, first one. Degree of minus 2019 divided by 2020 Okay, x to the power of 2019, y to the power of 2020, z is what? Okay, and options also take 2019, this first problem, 2020,
and third one,
4040, and fourth one, 4019, I mean 39.
Okay, consider this.
Now, this is what first of all, monomial. This is only one term. Okay. Now, the degree of that monomial we want to find. What the degree of monomial says what? The sum of the indices of all the variables in a term is nothing but degree of that term. That means the degree of that monomial. Okay, here, minus 2019 by 2020, what is that constant? And what are the variables x, y, and z? What are the indices 2019? For y variable, what is the index 2020, 2020? And z power nothing is, that means there must be 1. We have to identify that. Okay, now degree of that monomial is nothing but sum of all the indices. That means 2019 plus 2020 plus 1 also. Okay, if we add all of those, what do you get? 4040. That's right. Our answer is 3.
Next.
Okay, if suppose an expression I am taking f of x is equal to a naught plus a1x plus a2x square plus so on plus a100x to the power of 100 is a zero polynomial, then he is saying that given polynomial is already zero polynomial, he said, then a0 plus a1 plus a2 plus so on a100 is equal to 1. That is the question.
Okay? See that.
Here given a polynomial, what is that? F of x is equal to a0 plus a1x plus a2x square plus so on plus a100x to the power of 100.
That is a zero polynomial. Zero polynomial nothing but zero. That means this total value should be equal to what is that? Zero. Okay. Now, zero polynomial definition, what is that? That is a polynomial in that the coefficients of each and every term should be zero. That means here coefficient, what is that? Constant term coefficient itself. A0 is zero. And in the second term coefficient, what is that? A1. That is also equal to zero. A2 coefficient also zero. Like that, the coefficient all the terms in the last term, that means that is what is that? Totally, how many terms are there? Here x power 1, but here x power nothing is there. That means this is the constant. Totally 101 terms. Here 2, here 100 plus 1, 101. All these coefficients should be is equal to what is that? 0. Okay, now if we add all of them, a0 plus a1 plus a2 plus 1 plus a100, that is equal to 0 plus 0 plus 0, totally what do you get? 0. Here, this is very important. Zero polynomial nothing but there is a polynomial in that the coefficient of each and every term should be zero. Okay, next.
Okay, degree of. The polynomial. 5 by 2 x square y z
and
3 by 4 x y z plus 8 by 3 x cube y square minus 1 is what?
Here observe, given what? A polynomial. Let us write again.
Degree of that polynomial we want. 5 by 2 x square y z minus 3 by 4 x y z and plus 8 by 3 x cube y square minus 1. Okay, this is the polynomial.
Of course, here variables what are the x, y, z. Here totally how many terms are there? This is one term. This is second term. This is third term. Fourth term. Okay, four terms are existing because the terms are separating only by plus and minus we know already.
Okay, for finding the degree of the polynomial, first let us find the degree of each term. What is the degree of this one? Degree nothing but what is that? The sum of the indices of the variables contains in that term. X square, y power 1, z power 1. Add all of them, 2 plus 1 plus 1. 4 is the degree of this term. And what is the degree of the second term? 1, x power 1, y power 1, z power 1. 1 plus 1 plus 1, 3. And take the third term. Further degree also find out here variables x, y. Indices what are the 3, 2. Okay. The sum of those two, what is that? 5. And constant term, see. Constant term that is not 0. Other than 0, any constant term you take, its degree is 0. Suppose 0 is also itself is constant. 0 constant, what is that? We cannot define. That means we cannot assign any value for the degree of 0. Okay, degree of a non-zero constant is 0. Degree of 0 is not defined. Okay, see here, minus 1 is not 0. The constant degree, what is that? 0. Okay, among all the terms, all the degrees we verify, which is the greatest? 5. Okay, now degree of polynomial says what? The highest degree of all the terms in a polynomial is nothing but degree of that polynomial. That's why which is the highest degree among all those terms having, okay, this term having highest degree, that is 5. That's why the degree of this polynomial, what is that? 5.
Okay, next. Let us take another one.
And simply, 0 of 5x plus 4 is what? That is the question. 0 of that one is what?
0 nothing but what?
The value of the variable we have to take such that for that value, the total value of the expression should become 0. For that purpose, we take like this. Let us support that. 5x plus 4, we want that value, what is that? 0. From that 5x is equal to what? Minus 4, and x is equal to minus 4 by 5. Okay, this gives us the value of the variable. This process gives us the value of the variable. For that, the expression value becomes 0. If we want, we can verify. Verification also say 5 into x plus 4 I am taking. This is nothing but x replacing by minus 4 by 5. 5 we cancel, minus 4 plus 4, that is equal to 0. That's why the value of variable, what is that? Minus 4 by 5. For that, the value of the given polynomial becomes 0. That's why this value of the variable minus 4 by 5 is called 0 of the polynomial. Okay, next one. The largest of the zeros of the polynomial 3 by 2 into x plus 1 into x plus 2 minus 5 into x plus 1 is what? Okay, given a polynomial, now for that we may have zeros. Among all those zeros, which is the largest zero we want to find?
Okay, let us suppose take that one. 3 by 2 x plus 1. This is the given polynomial. 3 by 2 into x plus 1 into x plus 2. Minus of 5 into x plus 1. Okay, this is the given polynomial. Now, for that polynomial, we want to find out the zeros. After that, among all those zeros, which is the largest we want to find? For finding the zeros, let us equate the given polynomial equal to 0. Okay. Observe here, how many terms are there? In this, 3 by 2 into x plus 1 into x plus 2, this is one term, minus 5 into x plus 1, that is another term. For finding the zeros, let us take x plus 1, here also x plus 1 is the common factor. Okay, taking that one, x plus 1. Then what do you get here? The remaining factor, 3 by 2 into x plus 2, and minus 5, that is equal to 0. Again, simplify, x plus 1 into, what is that? 3 by 2 into x, 3x by 2, 3 by 2 into 2, 2, 2 will be cancelled, 3 minus 5, that is equal to 0. That means x plus 1 into 3x by 2 minus 2 is equal to 0. Here one factor, here one factor. The product of two factors 0 nothing but either first factor is 0 or second factor is 0. Okay, from that, x plus 1 equals 0 or 3x by 2 minus 2 equals 0. From that x is equal to what is that minus 1. From that answer, 3x by 2 is equal to 3x is equal to 4. X is equal to 4 by 3. That means x is equal to 1 by 3.
Okay.
Simply enough, 4 by 3. Now zeros are what? Minus 1.
And 4 by 3 we have. Okay, one second. This is the given polynomial. Now we want to find out the zeros. And among those zeros, largest zero we want to find. For that we take and we equated the given polynomial to 0. X plus 1 taken common. In this first term, if x plus 1 we take in common, the other factor what is the 3 by 2 into x plus 2 and in that minus 5. Okay, if we multiply it, we are getting this one. 3 plus minus 5, what is that? Minus 2. Upon simplification, x value we are getting 1 is 4 by 3 and another one is what is that? Minus 1. That means the zeros what are they? Minus 1 and 4 by 3. But here what we want? The largest of the zeros. Which is the largest zero? Is minus 1 or 4 by 3? 4 by 3 positive. That is the big question. That means the largest zero of the given polynomial is what? 4 by 3. Okay? Thank you.